Good morning, and welcome to the celebration of the Eucharist. I invite you to join us as we ask God to bless our lives, and please remember in your prayers the following people.
Good morning and welcome to the Eucharist, the Mass of the Eucharist. It helps us to know God a little better, and hopefully he will affect the way we think about him in improving our ability to carry the message of Christ to other people. Today's feast day is that of an interesting man who ultimately became a pope and a great doctor of the church. He had many things to say thank you for, but he chose a special way of saying thank you that many priests have learned is the symbol of recognizing who we really are. Servus servorum Dei. I am not someone that is glorying in his praise. I am here to be the servant of all others who serve. In that spirit, we begin. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and the grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, we pause for a moment to ask God's forgiveness for all our sins. You were sent to heal the contrite. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You plead for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who cares for your people with gentleness, you rule us with love. Through the intercession of Pope Saint Gregory, endow us with a spirit of wisdom, especially you have given authority to those who govern and those who flourish in guiding your flock. May we all become eternal joy to the shepherd in heaven. We ask this through your Son, Jesus Christ, who is the Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, learn from myself and Apollos not to go beyond what is written, so that none of you will be inflated with pride in favor of one person over against another. Who confers distinction upon you? What do you possess that you have not received? But if you have received it, why are you boasting as if you did not receive it? You are already satisfied. You have already grown rich. You have become kings without us. Indeed, I wish that you had become kings, so that we also might become kings with you. For as I see it, God has exhibited us apostles as the last of all, like the people sentenced to death, since we have become a spectacle to the world, to angels and men alike. We are fools in Christ's account, but you are wise in Christ. We are weak, but you are strong. You are held in honor, but we in disrepute. To this very hour, we go hungry and thirsty, and are poorly clad and roughly treated. We wander about homeless, and we toil, working with our own hands. When ridiculed, we bless. When persecuted, we endure. When slandered, we respond gently. We have become like the world's rubbish, the scum of all, to this very moment. I'm writing you this not to shame you, but to admonish you as my beloved children. Even if you should have countless guides to Christ, yet you do not have many fathers, for I became your father in Christ Jesus through the gospel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is near to all who call upon him.
The Lord hears all who call upon him.
The Lord is just in all his ways and holy in all his works. The Lord is near to all who call upon him, to all who call upon him in truth.
The Lord is near to all who call upon him.
He fulfills the desire of those who fear him. He hears their cry and saves them. The Lord keeps all who love him, but all the wicked he will destroy. The Lord is near to all who call upon him. May the mouth speak the praise of the Lord, and may all flesh bless his holy name forever and ever.
The Lord is near to all who call upon him. Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia.
I am the way, the truth, and the life, says the Lord. No one comes to the Father except through me. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus was going through a field of grain on a Sabbath day, his disciples were picking the heads of the grain, rubbing them in their hands, and eating them. Now some of the Pharisees saw this. "Why are you doing what is unlawful on the Sabbath?" they asked. Jesus replied, "Have you not read what David did when he and those who were with him were hungry? How he went into the house of God and took the bread of offering, which only priests could lawfully eat. He ate of it and shared it with his companions. And then he said to them, 'The Son of Man is the Lord of the Sabbath.'" The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I mentioned at the beginning of Mass that it's a great saint we honor, the saint of today, who has in many, many different ways had an effect on the life and really on the impact of many priests, many bishops, many people who've taken vows to serve the Lord. But it couldn't help when I reflected on his life that there is something I shouldn't say unique, but something is marvelous about how he treated what he was given. I'm going to refer primarily just to that first reading, which Marcus read earlier, Paul's letter to the Corinthians. I have a feeling that this saint, Saint Gregory the Great, realized, having read that letter of Paul to the Corinthians, what he must do if he truly was going to serve the church appropriately. In life, Gregory the Great, Gregory was a nobleman. At least two members of his family, going back several years, had become popes. It was somewhat in the tradition of the family that popes would come from that family. He had a good job, not a job in the church, but a job in government. And he did that fairly well until he realized what was happening to the church. It was the victim of many, many assaults from those outside the country, those who were trying to put the church down. He realized that there were many who lacked the real understanding of what it meant to be a part of the church and a servant of God. And he lacked and chose as his guiding rule that were those words I mentioned at the beginning of man. I am servus servorum Dei. I am the servant of all others who serve God. Somewhere along the line, he picked that up and he made a very simple decision. If I'm going to help the church, I'll try my best not to be its leader. And he hesitated when they wanted him to be a leader, but rather to serve other people. And then he made one of his many, many wonderful documents, one of which said, stop and ask yourself the question, what is the best thing you can do as an individual? What is it that you're gifted, perhaps? Is it music? Is it something you write? Is it something that you can create or build? Is something you can say by your speech? And before you go thinking one bit more about that gift, remember the simple phrase, it is a gift. Where was that gift given? At first in baptism, the gift of God, and thereafter, the more you knew what God left for us in so many different ways, it helped you to grow in your knowledge. And so, clearly, if you could lay claim to any of the great gifts that you have in life or may be respected by many others, his answer was, you've chosen a false way to show your thanks to God. It's not, I am great. I am thankful for the gifts. It's God, thank you for giving me those gifts. And then he added his own phrase. If we truly want to acknowledge the idea of a gift, then make for yourself the gift I make for my own self. Serve other people, the poorest, the needy, those who one way or another are the victims of violence in any way whatsoever. And constantly ask yourself what that first reading says. What confers distinction upon you? What do you possess that you have not received, but you have received it, so why should you boast about it? Thank you, God, for whatever gifts you give me. They are intended to be a source that will lead me and help others to be led by me and bring us closer to the gift that God gives all of us, a gift of life, a gift of love, a gift of hope, and a gift of faith. Never forget to say thank you in any gift you might receive compliment for. And so we pray. O Lord our God, we come before you to offer our needs, the needs of our community and the needs of the church in all parts of the world. We pray in a very simple way for all who are in need.
That we may help our people to the positive and hopeful, and to uphold Christian values by their words and deeds, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the world, that we may acknowledge and protect the dignity of each human life, from natural conception to natural death, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who support this televised Mass through their prayers, voluntary service, and financial contributions, may they experience the richness of God's kindness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in our faith community with special intentions, Father John Gatzak and staff, the Halish family, the Mark family, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our deceased friends and relatives, Anne Ganesh, Doris and Buckley Buckmiller, Dr. Thaddeus and Martha Novicki, Francis J. De La Camera, Maurice and Claire Lawlin, Roger O. Bernard, the Halish family, Valentino A. Cugagna, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O Lord our God, I offer one prayer for the repose of the soul of a good friend who died yesterday morning, Wendy Wheaton. May she be in the presence of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O Lord our God, you know our needs, whether they are expressed or held in the silence of our hearts. Answer them through your Son, Jesus, who is the Lord forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Please be seated. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
By the mystery of this wine and water, that we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this wine to offer, the fruit of the vine and the work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Lord God, we ask you to receive us. Be pleased with the sacrifice we offer with humble and contrite hearts. Lord, wash away our iniquities and cleanse us of our sins. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands
for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for all his holy church.
O Lord, grant our supplication that this sacrifice, which we present in celebration of Saint Gregory, may not be for others, but for the good of the church, since through this offering you have loosed the offenses of others throughout the world. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. We offer you, Lord, that we do this in honor of Saint Gregory, who you who led your church and taught us to remember we are servants, so too you strengthened the church by the example of his holy life. You taught us by the words of his preaching, and you kept us safe in answer to his prayers. And so in the company of all the angels and saints, we too join with you in the words of praise as together we say, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. O Lord, you are holy indeed, the font of all holiness, and so we pray. Send down your Spirit upon these gifts to make them holy, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, he entered willingly into his passion. He took bread, and giving thanks to you, his heavenly Father, he broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice once more. Giving thanks to you, his heavenly Father, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation. We thank you, for you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. So humbly we pray, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, may we be gathered into the one family of God by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Leonard, our Archbishop, and all those who help us to know and share our faith. Remember all our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection. All others who've died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your presence. Have mercy on us, we pray, that together with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, the apostles, the martyrs, Saint Gregory, whose feast we honor today, and all the saints who've pleased you throughout the ages, may we become merit to be co-heirs of eternal life. May we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray in the words that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all anxiety, as we wait with blessed hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I give you, my peace I leave you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant peace and unity in accordance with your will, you who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
May the mingling of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring us to eternal life, those who receive it. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ preserve us to eternal life. Let us pray. Through Christ the teacher, O Lord, instruct those you feed with the gift of this living bread, that on the feast day of Saint Gregory we may learn your truth and express it in charity. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us and the prayer to Saint Michael the Archangel. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. To thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world
seeking their own souls. Amen.
May Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.